come to this site. So at least if last class if you have not seen this, gone to this site, at least by today you try to visit this site. I have given this link in your chat box. So this is a virtual lab. This is nothing but they have written the code, that's all. Code is nothing but your equations governing your devices. So I think last class we have gone with a normal diode. Now we will go with the Zener diode. Now you should know the difference between normal diode and a Zener diode. Both are semiconductors. Both have N-type and P-type material. The variation is the doping level. The amount of impurities you add. The amount of impurities you add, which means you are increasing the number of holes and number of electrons in your P-type and N-type. When you say P, it is number of holes. If you say N, it is number of electrons. So adding impurities is nothing but the formation of bonding. You are trying to increase your number of holes and number of electrons. Okay, so that is what we do. So when you add impurities, what happens is at the normal operation, that is under forward bias condition, there won't be any change. The change will be there only if the diode is been reverse bias. So okay, so initially when you taken with the normal PN junction diode, always this flow of electron can be compared with the flow of water. So when you say compared with the flow of water, think of the condition where if the dam is fully filled, if the dam is filled to its rim, in that case if you try to open the valve, what will happen to the dam? So entire dam water will try to pass through and they will try to collapse. Same thing is happening in normal diode under reverse bias condition. You are going on increasing your potential. So potential is same as the amount of water. So if your potential is go on increasing, which means you have more free electrons, which means it is there but you are not allowing. That is what is happening in under reverse bias condition. So you are slightly, you are go on increasing your voltage. When you are go on increasing your voltage, what will happen is it is similar to a dam where water is getting accumulated and accumulated and goes on. And if at a very high voltage, if you suddenly open, the entire thing will collapse. Rather, in Zener, what you are going to do is that breakdown is not going to occur at a very high voltage. Rather, breakdown will occur at very low voltage itself. In Zener, now forward bias is same. Okay, it is a special kind of diode which permits current to flow in forward as normal, but also allow it to flow in reverse when the voltage is above breakdown voltage, or we call it as Zener voltage. You might have studied a breakdown called Zener breakdown and avalanche breakdown. Avalanche itself is multiple. When I gets multiple, which is nothing but your volume become very high, so at very high voltage you are breaking down. So at that very voltage, if you break, the entire thing will collapse. Here what you are doing in Zener is, it is at lower level itself you try to break. So when you break, automatically that voltage will not damage. Okay, so even you can see, for example, Zener has a reverse breakdown of 2.4 volts itself. Okay, so you should change the symbol slightly. So when you put a straight line, we call it as normal diode. You slightly bent at the corners, which is nothing but a Zener diode. Okay, the function of Zener diode is, it is used for voltage regulation. So whenever you want something, like when you have reached some voltage and you want to indication for that, you normally go for Zener, because you put a Zener diode in reverse bias condition, reverse direction, with series with an LED. So what happens if that voltage is reaching that particular value, your device will get breakdown. So your current starts to flow through the across the device, automatically your LED will get burned. So LED will glow, so that we can come to a conclusion that it has reached. Okay, so remaining part it is same. So now let us go to our lab session. So procedure for conducting is, you need a set the Zener voltage, then series resistance, then load resistance you have to put, then you have to vary the DC voltage. So when you vary the DC voltage, you will try to see what is the voltage increasing. Under forward bias condition it is same, only in reverse at a particular voltage this will starts to get turned on. So this is the figure for your Zener diode. Then there are different types of Zener. We will see what and all it is there. So let us go to simulation part. So in simulation, let us go with first one, which is you can see here. Now you can enter your Zener breakdown voltage whatever you want, okay, and you can write about your what is the series resistance and what is your load resistance. So you can this is your input side voltage variation, okay. So this is your breakdown voltage we are specifying. Then this is the input side resistance you can keep from this, and this is for load side resistance, okay. So whatever you want you can set the value, then you can start taking your readings, okay. So when you say if you want to plot, before plot you have to fill the tabular column. So add to table. So now you can add this. So I will do it again, I will show you. So this will be the screen which will be visible to you. So what is the first step for you is you have to say what is the input voltage. So should start with input voltage. You can keep at input voltage at a particular value. Say I am keeping at 2.4 volts I am keeping. Then you have to specify about Zener breakdown voltage. So Zener breakdown voltage you can at what voltage you want you can keep it. So I am let us keeping it in around 10 volts, or I can even keep it at 7.5. So this is left to you. I should not see a tabular column with all you with the same value. So you can, everybody can do it separately. So it is very easy. There is nothing difficult with this virtual lab, because only if you do in normal lab, then our voltmeter, multimeter and all will not be so accurate. So you will be unable to take the reading, but here that is the not the case. Okay, since it is virtual, it will show the accurate value. So you each and every person should keep a separate DC voltage, okay. Then Zener diode voltage also there should be variation. I will see the tabular column of you, so that you should keep each and see I can keep it at 13 different position. There is no problem because you are only 13 students you are there. So you can keep it at any place. This value you have to change between your 3.52. you can keep it till 10 volts, okay. So keep it at any particular value. So each and every person tabular columns will be separate, okay. It should not be just copying from others. And this resistance also you can keep low resistance or high resistance, but usually series resistance you can keep it as a low value. Then load depends upon the what is the type of power which is going to consume. When you keep high resistance, which means low power, when you keep low resistance it is high power. So all this you should note. So resistance if it is very high, don't think power is high, power is less. So when you keep very low resistance, very high power, okay. See, your 100 watts lamp will have more resistance than 1000 watts lamp, okay. Nowadays you doesn't see incandescent lamp at all. That what we say as you think as what Edison has invented. So that lamp I am saying it is called incandescent lamp, but nowadays we doesn't use, we use only CFL, or we will go for only LED or tube lights, okay. That olden days incandescent lamp now we are not using, but to understand I am saying 100 watts lamp will have high resistance compared to 1000 watts lamp, okay. When you say 1000 watts it has to consume very high power. So obviously if I want to consume very high power, there should be minimum resistance, then only I can consume more power. So load resistance, when you reduce the load resistance, the power across the load is increasing. When you keep high resistance, then power consumed by load is less. So try to keep it at any one particular position, okay. Now you just press this add to tabular column. So your first reading is ready, which means you have set the voltage 8.3, okay. You have set the resistance as 1.1 kilo ohms and you have set the load resistance at 1.7, okay. Now you can see here unregulated voltage is 2.4, then load current. Now your experiment is start. So what you have to do? Slightly go and increase your voltage. Keep at each and every position and take it as add to table. So I am gradually increasing and I am trying to add it in my table. You can see when the voltage increases, what happens? Your current also increases. So you try to take 10 readings. Okay, keep it at different values and try to take 10 readings. Okay, now you can see here we have totally taken 11 readings. Now you can go for plot. So when you plot, we can see there for increase in output voltage, your source voltage at after a particular instant becomes constant, which means once the device is completely turned on, then there won't be any increase in voltage. Voltage remains constant, only current starts to increase. So that is what we are able to see here. So initially there, for increase in voltage, there will be increase in voltage, then at a particular instant thereafter there won't be any increase in voltage. So this is with respect to this particular. So let us kindly come back. So here we have seen line regulation. Now as a diode characteristics, here what you have to do is, the difference is you have to go and connect this to, okay, all this connections you have to do. So this you can try it at home. So you can try to connect like this and try to see how you are going to connect your each and everything. Then since wherever you see voltmeter, it has to be connected in parallel. Wherever you see ammeter, you have to connect it in series. Okay, so all that thing. So just this is for a practice. So when you connect like this, then you can see here. So again, this is a voltmeter, so it has to be connected in parallel. So all this is just for your practice. So this you can do. Okay, again procedure and all is same as we are doing. What we have done, we have again doing, that's all. Okay, now you see I will keep it at a particular value, then I will add to table. I am putting, so I have taken. So it is like a similar way you can try to increase. Okay, now only difference between that and this particular thing here, you have to increase. Okay, so why we are doing this experiment is to see that you are going to now plot between your output voltage and load resistance. This is to say, I told you that the resistance only will decide about your current drawn. So purely depends upon resistance. So as you can see here, when your resistance is increasing, the output voltage will increase and current will come down. Okay, that is cautious. Just put a note and take a note on your note or rough note. So whenever you go and increase your resistance, see, when you go and increase your resistance, what happens is, obviously your current will come down. If your current is coming down, your voltage will increase. The reason is power remains constant, power cannot be varied. So when there is drop in current, obviously your voltage will increase. So that is called as load regulation. Now let us come to characteristics. This is what we have done in our last class, where we have done for normal diode. So you can select any one type of Zener diode which is there. So you can, dear students, kindly you see there, this is the first one where 5.6 is the reverse. Okay, reverse breakdown. So for each and every brand, when you go there, you have to specify what is the breakdown voltage. See, this is a peculiar. See, IN 4733A is as a 5.1 breakdown. So when you want to set up any such thing that you have to break down at a particular value, then that value you have to select from this. So there are so many types of Zener diode which is available, like 3.5, breakdown voltage is 3.5, breakdown voltage is 5, breakdown voltage is 6.2, like that you have so many options are there. You just fix it at any one particular value. Let us say fix it at 3.6. okay, now what you have to do is you have to, so this is your current. So initially it will not be there, your current will be zero only if it is crossing your breakdown voltage. What is your breakdown voltage you have kept? It is 3.5. So this is the value at which, see, you can see slightly. Now when I increase further, I will go in step because then only that you can identify the graph. So I have selected a particular thing, then I am going to vary this resistance. This is RH resistance I am varying. So by varying this, the input side voltage will change, and we are going to see about the conduction of that particular thing. So I am just putting a particular value. Until that value, see, thereafter you can see once it has crossed, now the current starts increasing. So what they mean to say is I have kept a low value of Zener diode, so it is not going beyond that particular thing. You can even keep at some, I think we have seen somewhere 9 and all. So you can keep that value and you can see then further some more there will be increase in value. So when you keep like this, you can even add the table. I will clear so it will get confused. So this is between the output current and your change in voltage. Once what is the set value you have reached, then till that instant it was, there was no current, and when it reaches the set value, it becomes, current starts to flow on your load side. Okay, so that is with respect to Zener diode. So only thing difference between a normal diode and a Zener diode is normal diode will have a very high breakdown, whereas Zener diode you will have breakdown at very lower value. So that is what is Zener meant for. So you can try to do all this, where draw circuit which is shown, this is just all the components will be present. You have to just pick that component and try to do. Okay, so let us go to the one more experiment today. That is, last class we have seen with diode. Now let us move on to an application of diode that is called as half wave rectifier. So I think you might have studied rectifier and all. Rectifier is nothing but which is going to convert AC current into DC current. So AC current, which is nothing but alternating in nature, alternating nature current is converted into direct current, which is you will have only in one direction. So from EB what you are getting is alternating current, and all the appliances at your home what you are having is only alternating in nature. So you don't want to go for rectifier and all. Whereas when you come for your mobile charger, your mobile phones and all is working in direct current. So in that case, what you want? You want direct current for charging your mobile. In that case alone, you will go for rectifiers. Okay, so you can even do rectifiers and you can try to create voltage which is required for your mobiles to charge. So what you have to do is, what is the speciality of the diode? Normal diode. Diode will conduct only in one direction and does not allow in the reverse direction. So what happens? This AC, what you say, it will be alternating in fashion, which means it will have both in positive half cycle as well as negative half cycle. But diode, what you have seen, will conduct only in one direction. I have told in reverse bias it will not conduct. So what happens? Bidirectional is been converted into unidirectional. Unidirectional is nothing but DC. Are you able to understand? So I repeat, alternating fellow will have both in positive as well as negative, which has been converted into unidirectional, which is called direct current. How it has been done is with the help of diode, because diode has a property of only allowing in forward direction, and reverse direction it will not allow. Once if you say it will not allow in reverse direction, what happens? Negative part of your off AC cycle is cut, so only you get positive output, which is nothing but your rectified output or DC output. Okay, that is what with this. Let us go to, this is just an oscilloscope tutorial. What is oscilloscope, what is knob and all, so what is x axis, what is y axis and all. Now this is not required for us. Let us go to simulation. So simulation of half wave rectifier. So you can see here I am having a sine wave here. See, previous experiment and all we have dealt with the DC directly. Now I am going with sine. What is sine is for is, it will have both positive as well as negative, but our fellow, who is nothing but this diode, will allow only in one direction, and reverse direction he will not allow. I have told this arrowhead is indicating it will allow flow of electron in this direction, and this straight line is indicating reverse is not permitted. So from this side electron is not permitted, so electron is permitted to enter only this direction and it can leave. So let us start from here. So in AC input, what will happen? Initially during positive half cycle, you will have electron will flowing in this direction. It, so when electron is entering in this direction, what will happen? This diode will allow. So automatically this diode will allow. So the electron will start flowing and they will try to come to load. Okay. Now load receives the input. So what is the shape of your input? Now is the same in case of across the load. Now what happens? Negative half cycle. Negative half cycle, electron will try to start from here and it will try to go to this load, but it will not try to pass this diode and it will not try to come to close. So in an open path there won't be any flow of current, so nothing will flow because of this diode. Since the diode opened the path, we might have studied current flow only in closed path. When the path is open, current will not flow. That is the reason why birds on EB line get shock. So edanala shock, it is not getting shock because it is not touching the next line. If that crow or any that particular bird touch the next line or the post at the same instant, what will happen? It will receive very high current and it will get die. Okay, so that you can see in some crows, they might have sit in a pole and touch a wire. You are supposed to stay on any one. Even if you try to hang from your EB line without touching the next line or ground, you will not receive any shock because your path is open. In open, there won't be any flow of current. Okay, so now when you start this experiment, keep it at some particular ohms, then you try to increase the voltage division probe. Here what you have to do is, let us see the instruction first. So set the resistance, that is what I have told, then click on button to start the experiment. Let us see where is that on button here. So let us see, I think some issue with my laptop. So it was touching each and every corner automatically. So I think like mouse problem it has happened. So again we will come back. Can you hear my voice? Dear students, can you hear? Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, some small minor problem. I think my laptop is a touchscreen laptop, and it has started touching each and every point by its own. So I was unable to control. That is what has happened. Now you can see here the instruction they given is they have asked us to keep at a particular resistance. Then they say click on button to start the experiment. So we will see where it is. That on button is here. They say there is some on button, so here it is. So try to click this on button. So once this is on button is there, we have done. Second thing what they ask us is what is the frequency which you want to keep, okay, amplitude and all. So we will see the instruction again. So we have now armed it. Then click on sine wave button to generate the input. So we will see where it's the sine wave button. So once you press this sine wave button, then we will able to see this sine wave. So you can even do by this, by increasing the frequency. So this is maximum frequency, then I am reducing the frequency. All this you can do, and this is with respect to amplitude. So when you want to see with greater amplitude, so this is what your input is, okay. So I repeat, this is what your input is. You press on button, that is the first step. Once you have press on button, press sine wave. So once you get the sine wave, you can see here that depending upon your magnitude, we are able to get. So now what is the, we will see the instruction. What is the next step? Okay, so first step we have seen, we have kept on resistance value. So here you can keep it at resistance, say my laptop is touch screen. I think there is some issue in touch screen, so it is not selecting what is required. So you can, yeah, same again, the problem starting. Okay, so you can see here, you can on sine wave you have done, then click on oscilloscope button. So click on oscilloscope button. So when you click on oscilloscope button, then we will see what is. So you can see here now what happens. So when you click on oscilloscope, so what I have told is it will allow only in positive off cycle this diode, negative off cycle it does not allow. So you can see here, so input you have seen, input was in bidirectional. Now that bidirectional input has been single direction. Even if you vary the frequency, you can see here. So when you vary the frequency and you can even vary the amplitude, you can see now only negative part is positive part is there and negative part is totally removed. Okay, this is half wave rectifier. The name half wave is given because only half of your input is getting rectified. Only half is being there in your output side. So only it is called as half wave rectifier. So even from first we will say you have to keep on resistance value. Then click on start of the experiment. There is an on button at the bottom. Then you have to click on sine wave. Then you have to click on oscilloscope. When you click on oscilloscope, you can see here, then vary the frequency, amplitude and all they have told. Then dual mode is there. Dual is you can see input as well as output. So let us see, you put it on dual. So when you see dual, you can see here, see it is there on positive half cycle and negative. Blue is indicating your input side, okay. So and your orange is indicating your output. So when you can clearly see that the output you can have only for one half and the other part is removed, okay. So that is with respect to your rectification of half wave into from your input of full wave rectifier. So your input is sine. In that sine, only half portion is there on the load and the half is being removed. The removed is negative, only positive half cycle is there. So it is called as half wave rectifier, okay. So at least if you have not gone through last lab class, try to go through this particular website and try to tell me. So with this we will stop today, and let us, if you have any doubts,